Hey guys, welcome back to Sudoku Maniacs. Now we are just 5 hours away from the launch of our mobile app, so I thought why not create a video on the features that will be available to you on the mobile app. Now this app right now is only for the Android, platform. The iOS version will be launched in the coming 2 to 3 months. So what we have done is, we have added a link to the Play Store on the homepage of our website. So if you go to our website on your mobile phone, the homepage will display the link. Click on that, it will take you directly to the Play Store where you can download the app. Once you have downloaded, click on it and it will open up. Now the best part is your existing Sudoku Maniacs ID will work on the app, so you can sign in using that. Alright, and once you are signed in, it'll give you a success message and it says that you are signed in. Now let's quickly have a look at all the features that we have. The contest and the contest archives are very much clear. The archives are the archive sections that we have on our website. Now for now, again, like our website, you select the date and you play the Sudoku on the archives. Now, I know I had promised you that we are adding a couple of features which will allow you to filter the archives by the difficulty level of the Sudoku and also by variant name. Now, as I had mentioned, it will take a couple of weeks because we have more than 1,000 Sudokus in the archives and I have to solve all of them actually to assign a difficulty level to them. Because when we launched the website, we never had this force, we didn't have this farsightedness that we might require the difficulty level down the line. So unfortunately, I'm stuck solving these 1,000 Sudokus, which will take me at least a couple of weeks, apart from the daily activities that I have. And once that is done, once all the Sudokus have the difficulty levels tagged to them, then those features also will be, and search features will also be enabled. So kindly bear with us for the next couple of weeks. You click on the daily contest, it takes you to the contest homepage and you'll see two tabs. One is the classic, one is the variant. So it will tell you which, for example, I have completed the classic for today. So it shows my time that I have taken. And also, if I want to play it again as practice, I can do it. The most important part here is the time remaining. Now this time remaining is nothing to do, it has nothing to do with your solving, but this is more for all our international players because the puzzles change at midnight India time. So the people in other countries, they do not have to worry about the time conversion to see what time it is in India based on their local time. The app itself will directly tell you how much time is left before the puzzle changes based on the date. So for example, right now it says that we have nearly 5.5 hours where this puzzle will be active, post which the new puzzle for the 25th would be displayed. So let's click for this practice. I want to practice this again. The first thing it does is it displays the rules. You can simply click on dismiss. And if in the middle of solving, say for example, for a variant, you're not clear of the rule, you click on this question mark at the top right, rules will pop up again, read it, dismiss it. Alright, now we have the numpad and we have three buttons below them. The extreme right is to reset the puzzle. If you click on it intentionally or unintentionally, it will just ask you to reconfirm whether you actually want to reset or not. When you click on OK, it gets reset. The central button is to take back step. Alright, if you want to retrace your steps. And then the extreme left, which is the most important, this is for pencil marking. So if you want to put in pencil marks in a cell, highlight this icon and say I want to highlight the cell where you want to put the pencil marks and simply click on the digit. So I wanted to place say 2, 3, 4 as pencil marks there. I simply highlighted the cell, clicked on 2, 3, and 4 and they got input as the pencil marks. And if you want to go to normal mode of solving, just uncheck the pencil mark and you come back to normal mode. So here, since this cell is highlighted, if I click on backspace, it will remove those digits. Now, normal mode. Say I want to place a digit in this cell. I highlight the cell and I see 5, 5 digit. I highlight it, press on the digit, it places. Then highlight, I put the 5. Now obviously this can be time consuming for some, and if say for example you want to fill in the same digit in multiple cells, there's a different way you can do it. So for now, we just unselect that cell. It's all a blank grid. You first highlight the digit in the numpad which you want to place. So you want to place all the 5s. Once you have done that, just look, just click on the cells where the digit has to be placed and it will get placed automatically. So now for example, I want to place the digit 6. I have a 6, 6, 6. I just keep on clicking on the cells, right? And the digit 6 gets placed, right? So let's say I want to place 9s, 9, 9, this would be a 9, this is a 9, this is a 9, this is a 9, this is a 9. I know the solution, so in the interest of time, I'm just kind of quickly running through, you know. So this would be a 2, 2, 2. This would be a 2, 8, 2, 8. All right, very well. Now we have 8s. That would be an 8, 8, 8, 8. Mm-hmm. All right. So that's an 8. That's an 8. So I'm just randomly wrapping it up quickly. Have we gone through all? Okay, the 3 would be there, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2. Okay, did we miss this one? 2, 2, 4. And once it's in, it gives you the congratulatory message and it says you completed the time. But since it was practice, your original solving time, the first time you solve, will obviously be the actual solving time. All right. So when you click on full results, it shows you the results of all the people who have solved that day. All right. This is about the daily one. Now we come out of it. If you want to see the monthly ranking, these bars that you see, they take you to the monthly ranking. Now I'm just going to tilt the phone because we have added the column of the country so that you know who, which country guy is playing, how many games they played, what is their actual score, and since it's in the landscape mode, and this is how you scroll through your monthly ranking. So irrespective of whether you solve the daily Sudokus on the website or on the app, your results will be updated and it will be a combined standing, as in there is no separate standing for the people who solve on the website or some people who solve on the app. Now, as I had mentioned, we are also going to introduce the global ranking system. This is something additional to the daily and the monthly standings that we have. So what happens is, the star that you see, you click on it, it takes you to the rating system. By default, every player is assigned the base rating of 1500. And based on your performance, your rating will improve or decrease compared to the how other people have solved. So if somebody who is higher ranked than you, but if on a specific day you score a higher rank than them, so you gain a lot of points and you climb. This is very similar to the ELO ratings that are there in chess. And this is an ongoing rating. It's not going to be refreshed at any time. So the more you play, the more you have the scope of increasing your rankings. And how that would appear is, this is obviously some dummy data that we have used. So based on how you score on a daily basis, your ratings will increase or decrease, and then you will be able to see where you stand globally. So this is some new feature that we have. Sorry about that. So this is a new feature that we have added on the website. And finally, one new thing, we have this theme of the light and dark. So this is the light theme that is presently there. And we also enabled the dark theme. You can select the dark theme. And now this is the dark theme. So it's completely up to you which theme you want to use. So this is all that I had to share about the app with you. Hope you guys like this, and I look forward. And yes, once you have downloaded, played on it, please do not forget to rate the app on the Play Store and leave a comment, because we might have missed out some, what do you say, improvement that you would love to see. So do let us know if there is something else you would like to see in the app, and we'll definitely try to make sure we incorporate that. So I look forward to your support in this. Please download the app from the Play Store tomorrow. And a very happy Dasara to all my friends across the world. May you have a prosperous time ahead. Thank you guys. Happy solving.